stopped in his tracks. It had been some time since James and Gordon played their trick on Percy. I say, Gordon, crowed James. My signal's gone up instead of down. What shall I do? Ask Percy, Gordon laughed. He's our expert. Percy thought their joke was getting old.
Never mind what those big engines say, Toby soothed. They're just being silly.
But you have to admit, Toby, it was rather funny.
Shut up!
Squeaked Percy, who quickly shut his eyes and went to sleep. The next morning, there was a slow goods train for the big station in the yard. James tactfully made himself scarce, so Percy brought the train. That afternoon, James was sleeping in the corner of the yard. He was most comfortable.
Wake up, James, said the inspector. The fat controller wants you to take some trucks to the other end of the line.
Get Percy to do it, James muttered.
He's not here. You left him to pull the other train, remember? Come along, fat controller's orders.
James stopped grumbling then. James trundled down the main line, his trucks clattering obediently behind. He rounded the bend and saw a signal. It was at danger. James brought himself to a stop and waited. As he waited, Gordon rushed past with the express. Later, Gordon was surprised to find that James hadn't moved since he last saw him.
Goodness me, James, exclaimed Gordon. Don't you think you should have gone by now?
James pondered.
Maybe you're... No, Gordon, he said, too loud on purpose. I know my signals. Up means stop. If it's at danger, I'll wait.
Gordon didn't know what to say, so he said nothing and left James on his own.
Come on. It'll change soon. Come on, it'll change right about now.
Beep, beep, beep. Wake up, James.
Percy.
James fumbled.
Keep quiet, or you'll wake up the other engines. Two?
Did you fall asleep waiting for the signal to change?
Percy ventured.
What? No,
James snapped.
I wouldn't expect you to understand.
Then maybe I will, thundered a familiar voice.
Sir, I was doing what the signal told me.
The signal is broken, the fat controller rapped. Why didn't you let the signalman know you were there?
James was about to reply, but Percy did for him.
James is an expert on signals, sir.
Percy smiled sweetly.
He's taught me all about them.
So, you were behind that little backing signal incident. Then, perhaps what you have in knowledge, young James, you lack in common sense.
James had never started as fast in all his life. James hoped no one knew about his mistake, but it was too late. The news spread fast, and when he pulled into the station at the end of the line, he saw engines all grinning and looking at him. As he left for home, some other trucks that had heard the story too called out.
We're usually the ones who stop your trains,
they yelled.
But we've never heard of an engine holding any of us back.
James blushed. He went as red as himself. Or a signal.